I could start a new adventure by jumping on my bed. I can wake up Mr. Nilsson, carry horse above my head. I can dance a shoddish, spread magic everywhere. I can skate around the kitchen, flip pancakes in the air. We'll do handsprings in the classroom, we'll do anything I want. Villa Villa Coola is waiting for us. What shall I do today?
What shall we do today?
What shall I do? What shall I do today?
What shall we do today?
What shall I do today? What shall I do?
Well, blow me down, my dear. I still can't figure out what happened to that lifeboat.
Some needy person found it, Father. They're probably out for a nice row right this minute.
Oh, it's no use. We're done for. We should have stayed on the Hoptoad. In fact, we should never even have left home.
Sorry.
No, I'm the one who should be sorry. It's all my fault. I'm sorry I treated you like a dumbbell.
That's all.
And like a servant. And a numbskull, and an inch of poop, and a nitwit, and a... What's that? It's a boat!
Help!
We're saved! Why aren't you rowing, you pea brain? Hi there!
Can we come aboard, please?
Maybe, and maybe not. What are a couple of landlubbers doing way out here anyway?
We were looking for pearls.
Yeah, no, wait. He means...
Shut up, you! Pearls, you say, huh? Go on.
See, we met this fat captain who lives on an island with mountains of pearls and...
A fat captain on an island?
That's right. Rescue us and we'll show you where it is.
But we don't know him.
Ignore him. He gets confused sometimes. So, is it a deal?
You bet!
Yes!
Except for one thing. We already know where the fat captain lives. We just didn't know he had all those pearls. Thanks for telling us.
Yeah, we really appreciate it.
By the way, there's an island just over there. And thanks again!
Moron, halfwit, idiot, pinhead, doughhead.
Would you mind hoisting up the last of the cargo, my dear?
Coming right up. There you are, Father.
That's not quite what I had in mind, but thank you nevertheless. Are you sure you won't come with us?
No, thanks. I like visiting relatives, but only if they're mine.
All right, then. And don't forget, when you've filled the bucket with pearls, take it to the Pearl Cave.
The Pearl Cave? Where's that? I'll show you later. Bye. See you later.
Bye.
Take us out, Mr. Friedolf.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Where is this Pearl Cave?
That's what Pippi's going to show us.
Now, where's Mr. Nilsson? Playing with his friends again. Have a good time, then.
Wait for me!
Whoa! Whoa! hard to get to.
Only if you don't know the way. Come on, I'll show you.
No, I mean, some other time, thank you.
What a great place. I wonder if that water's deep enough to swim in.
Oh, sure, it's plenty deep.
That's all I need to know. Look up below!
Of course, it is a shark pool.
You mean it's full of sharks?
Oh, no, no, not always. Sometimes there's only one or two.
Sharks! Tommy! Get out, get out! What? Come on in, it's really warm.
Oh my gosh, is that a shark?
It is! Shark! Shark! What did you say? What's the matter?
Hey, that looks like a...
Your fault, Pippi.
Oh.
I shouldn't have jumped in without checking. Anyway, it doesn't matter now. He missed me. I'm fine.
That's not why I'm sad.
What do you mean?
It's that poor shark. He thought he had a tasty breakfast all lined up, and now he'll have nothing to eat at all.
Oh.
Huh?
That's the island, all right. That's weird.
What?
The place looks deserted. Even that fat captain and his boat are gone.
Oh, ain't that too bad.
It ain't so good, neither. We don't know where they hide the pearls. Wait a second. Somebody's coming.
Shake my wooden leg.
It's some little kids. All we gotta do is get a bunch of children to show us the hiding place, and we're rich. No rough stuff. We use our brains.
But if that don't work...
Don't worry, it will. Get dressed. We're almost in.
Who do you think it is?
Probably just tourists.
Too bad nobody else is here.
Well then, we'll just have to be especially friendly to them to make up for it.
They don't look like tourists to me.
Well, what else would they be?
Hi, welcome to Kura Kuradat.
Why, thank you. That's very friendly of you. Are you here all alone?
I'm afraid so. Everyone else went to the next island for a visit. But we'll try to make your visit as enjoyable as possible.
Oh, I'm sure we'll enjoy ourselves.
Yeah.
What would you like to do first? How about fishing?
Well, now...
You can go shark catching, or octopus grabbing, or turtle snapping, or swordfish dueling.
Oh, sounds like fun. But have you got anything a tad smaller? Say, about this size?
I'm afraid not. Unless you count pearls, of course.
Pearl fishing? Go on!
Here's one I just got the other day.
Ha, 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 ha! You mean to say the pearl beds are right down there?
All around that rock. There are so many oysters. They go crunch, crunch under your feet when you walk on the bottom. And everyone has a giant pearl inside.
That sounds really interesting. Do you mind if we look around a bit down there?
Oh, not at all. But the guardian oyster might.
The what?
The guardian oyster. Don't you know about him?
No.
You see, it all started quite a while ago. For centuries, the islanders and the oysters got along just fine. Every year, on Oyster Appreciation Weekend, the people would help the oysters build new beds. And on People Appreciation Day, the oysters would present the islanders with their finest pearls. But then, other people found out about it, and oyster poachers rushed in to try to grab the pearls for themselves. They were greedy. They didn't care that if they didn't stop, there would soon be no oysters left. They were destroying everything. Then one day, just when things looked blackest, a giant oyster came out of the west. He had the biggest pearl anyone had ever seen. And he could close his shell faster than any oyster in the ocean. It wasn't long before all the boats and all the poachers went away. So did the giant oyster, because he had other work to do and other beds to save. But he promised that if ever any poachers came again, he would too. So you better check with him first.
Is that really true?
No way. What do you take us for, huh? Guardian oyster, my foot. Aren't you ashamed of yourself, telling tall tales like that?
No. Pippi's never ashamed. Right, Pippi?
That's true.
Wait a second. You mean there ain't no man-eating oyster down there?
No, only a giant octopus.
Ha! Sure it wasn't a big, bad goldfish? Good try, kid, but we're going down.
Of course, octopuses are very hard to measure, so maybe it isn't. You never know what you should be measuring.
You think I can't outsmart some little storytelling red-haired kid? Well, watch this.
Oh, I just hate to leave Kappa Kappa Cup without seeing some of those pearls.
That would be disappointing, wouldn't it? You could show them the ones in your bucket, Tommy.
I don't think I should. I'm supposed to be guarding them.
Oh, please.
Just so we could tell people we saw them. Aren't you supposed to be nice to tourists?
Go on, Tommy.
Oh, all right.
There.
Quiet. My, don't they shine? They sure would make nice souvenirs.
And marbles.
What?
They make good marbles, too.
Marbles? Marbles! You mean they play marbles here?
It's the national sport of Kurukuradat.
Tommy won the championship for his age group.
He did? Well, congratulations. Now, I know you're much better than me, but I'd be honored to shoot a game with you.
You want to play me?
Just for fun, so I could say I played the champion.
But you don't have any marbles.
Well, maybe we can fix that. We'll trade you all this stuff from the boat for some of your marbles.
Hey, that's my...
Don't worry. I used to be a marbles champ. I'll clean the kid out. Okay?
Well...
What if you lose, Tommy? You think I can't beat him?
Of course, if you're afraid.
I'm not afraid. All right, you're on. Let's play.
Pippi!
We can't interfere, Annika. Tommy gave his word. And on Kura Kura Dut, as the old saying goes, your word is your oyster. Play marbles!
All right!
Over there.
Oh, yeah, I didn't see that. Thanks.
Go, Tommy!
Yeah!
Yeah!
Ooh. Hey, that's the whole bunch.
Yeah. Tell you what, boy. How about we play for all the marbles, huh? One shot, winner takes all. I'll throw in everything we got, even the clothes off our backs.
I don't know.
You're not nervous, are you, champ? Come on, deal?
Deal, if I can take the shot.
Why, sure, honey bunch. My pleasure. Get those clothes off, Buck.
Don't miss, Pippi, please, or I'm in big trouble.
Girls can't play marbles. It's in the bag.
Show them, Pippi.
All right,
yay, Pippi!
Nice shot!
I'll just put our winnings in a safe place while Tommy picks up the pearls.
Now! All right, kid. I'll take them pearls.
Run, Annika!
Get after them!
Come on!
Wait! Isn't that the wrong way?
Down there!
Horse!
Well,
It'll be horse meat when I drop this boulder on it, unless you fork over the pearls. Give me a hand.
Run away, horse!
It's no use. He only listens to me.
Run, horse, run!
That is, when he listens at all.
Almost off!
Stop! You win. We'll bring them right over.
Careful, boss. It might be a trick.
Yeah. Just a minute! You leave them there, and we'll go over and get them.
Whatever you say. Here we come.
Thought you could outsmart me, huh?
Now they'll find all the pearls, and it'll be my fault.
Well, you never know. Maybe things will turn out all right. But before anything else, you better take horse to safety.
Giddy up! Run, horse!
Go! Go!
Boss, look! Pearls! Millions of them!
No! Billions! This must be their storage place! Rich! Rich! Rich.
I'm rich! You're rich! We're all rich!
Wait, hold it. We better get this stuff out of here before the islanders come back. Fill your
pockets? I ain't got no pockets.
We lost our pockets.
How are we gonna carry it?
I don't know. Let me think. No. We'll have to go back and get a sack, that's all.
What if she's waiting for us?
They're gone. Come on! Jump!
Hey, whoa!
What?
Uh-oh.
Now I know you were just fooling about hurting horse, weren't you?
Yes!
And I know you want me to donate that stuff you lost to the children's home, don't you?
Yes!
And I know you're going to get into your boat and sail away and never come back, aren't you?
Yes!
I thought so! I'd swim fast if I were you! There are sharks down there!
Well, now, me hearties, anything exciting to report?
Can't think of anything. Oh, some tourists stopped by, that's all.
I hope you showed them a good time.
We did our best, and I'm sure they had a time they'll never forget.